seeing very interesting table. Let us see what our rabbis tell us about the importance of the month of Nisan, the month of Passover. So Rabbi Yeshua convinced that in Nisan the universe was created, therefore in Nisan the Jewish people were redeemed, and in Nisan they will be redeemed once again. Tracy. This is Talmud Rosh Hashanah 10b. So one can see there is an interesting argument there, but Rabbi Yeshua's idea is normally accepted that really Nisan is a time of redemption. Also Nisan in Hebrew means from Nes, Nisin, miracles can happen like it happened in Egypt. So let us hope that will be happen. But let us see very, very interesting, significant table, hoping that really it will come, because there are a lot of important teachings behind this, and also it is very significant, as you see yourself, because what makes a table appropriate in the right Torah code table is when it is minimal, when it has meetings, when it's parallel. Many times I told you, these are what really Dr. Rottenberg, Russian scientist now in Israel, became very orthodox after seeing the phenomena of the codes. He made this program that I'm using, and this is what he said, parallel minimals are the most important part, even more than statistics. So let us see what we have here, which is really unbelievable. So I wanted to see whether this Passover will be Messiah, redemption, because you know, this is really Passover, is a time of redemption, of Egypt in the past and of in the future, we saw. So, it came once in the Torah, 5779, this year Passover. Not simple, once in the Torah, this way. Then, after seeing this, I wanted to know whether Messiah is here. So interesting, there is Mashiach here, you can see Messiah. And again Messiah, the son of Joseph, son of David. And the most interesting, that parallel came son of Jesse, Ben Ishai. And I said, parallel is not something that you can decide and put it parallel. No, the table brings it as we see it. Yeah? We only tell the table words, and the table brings us the words. So interesting, son of Jesse, parallel to 5779 Passover, and Messiah, Messiah. Now what is the most interesting in this table is the condition for redemption. Redemption comes here, even hidden redemption. And what is the interesting idea? The most important principle for redemption is repentance, Hatshuva. Here comes the minimum in the Old Torah, Hateshuva, the repentance. And this is a story about the Egyptians who were chasing Israel. And it's written of Pharaoh, Ikrib, Pharaoh came near. And Israel saw the sea in front, the Egyptians in the back, and the desert, the sides, what can they do? So they cried and shouted to God, as is written here. And they did Shuvah, repented, they integrated in the Hebrew word, Ikrib. He brought their Pharaoh, brought their heart near to repentance. Yeah. This is exactly what happened. Really, they repented, they prayed to God, and then Mary's the great miracle of the splitting of the Red Sea, and then they sang as Yashir, then they sang, and this is the future, this song will come back. So, amazing table, as we said, minimal, parallel. Then, what I found here very, very interesting, Purim comes here again, Purim. Not so simple to find, almost parallel. What is the connection? So it is very famous in Judaism that Purim is really the beginning of the process of redemption. It's written the rule in Jewish law that 30 days before something is already the process started. So Purim, 30 days before Passover, it is the beginning of the process of redemption. Now Purim, it is called hidden miracle, this is why hidden redemption, interesting. And Nisan, in Hebrew, Nisan comes from Nisim, really, miracles, but clear ones. This is Hebrew, Nisan. Adar is only in Hebrew come from Adere, which is like a mass, a cover. Amazingly, you have here the idea of Purim, as we saw other tables, that this Purim, hoping the Jews will do tshuva, will repent, not breaking the Sabbath, unfortunately, dedicating the Shabbos, and what is today we see in the elections of those, you know, those the heads of all these, you know, all kind of parties, Kachol Lavan, White Red, Gantz, and Lapid, and the others, all really said, no, we will have the creation of the Sabbath, the transmit of Shabbos, civil marriage, all this against God, against the Torah, no, difficult. But you hope they will do tshuva, who knows, maybe a situation will come, who knows if a war or book. But hoping that, as the Maimonides said, that Israel will not be redeemed unless they repent, do tshuva. But God promised that they will do it, no, you know, maybe because of the situation. Now, what is also interesting, when I saw in the table, it means the problem, you cannot see it because it's a small area, but in fact, before Ben Ishai comes there, who is really? It means, as I mentioned a few places, that our rabbi said that there are four messiahs, means four names basically for the messiah, and those are Shiloh, and this is Menachem, this is Inon, and Chanina, which doesn't come from completely here because of the small table, but the first name also. Definitely that means that we'll have four messiah, but we'll have, but in Hebrew means Menachem, somebody will comfort us after all the problems the Jews went through, yeah. And then we'll have Shiloh is Shiloh, that the world will realize the greatness of Jews, of Messiah, so bring Shiloh, bring present to him. Then Inon, it comes from the kingdom, and Chanina means that we'll have mercy on Jews. So amazing that you have all this coming here. You have the temple, because definitely this is a part of the purpose of the Messiah. It means it's really one of the things he's supposed to do, to bring the temple, to build up the temple. And salvation will come also here. So altogether, as we said, you have this table, which you have minimal 5, 7, 7, 9. Passover. You have parallel the son of Jesse. And you have parallel Atshuva, repentance, and exactly the same situation like today. At that time was Pharaoh who chased them on to destroy, to kill them, to bring them back to Egypt, whatever it is, but exactly what we have today. We have Iran from one side, you have Hezbollah, also the same thing, also want to wipe out Jews. Then, as I said, the idea of Purim connected with Passover coming is also very interesting. And Messiah, son of Yosef, Messiah, son of David, son of Jesse, and Elijah, we will come definitely with all of them together. This is what we have in Passover. Seder, we have the cup of Eliyahu, Kos Eliyahu, the cup of Elijah, definitely. Indicating to his coming back to redeem us. So interesting and significant tables, I said. And one really should look at it properly and understand what is in the Torah called table, because people make for you also table. When you look at it, it is no connection, words are not connected, no minimal, no parallel. So, interesting and important table for our time, hoping that really this Purim and this Pesach will be times of redemption, Messiah, salvation, peace, tranquility in Israel, in the whole world.